When the Houston Lyceum and Carnegie Library Association opened its first public library building in 1904, the centerpiece of its holdings was the John Ephraim Thomas Milsaps collection.
John Ephraim Thomas Milsaps was a major in the Salvation Army who grew up in Houston. In 1904, when the Houston Public Library first opened, the collection that he gave to the library was the centerpiece of the library's collection, and it still is today to a large extent.
Between 1904 and 1932, he donated 12,000 books and 3,000 pamphlets to the library. Milsaps' autobiographical diaries, comprising 74 volumes depicting his daily life and travels, are an invaluable insight into the social history of his time. Julia Bedford Ideson was Houston's first professional librarian and first director of the Houston Public Library, where her career spanned 42 years. In 1976, when the new Central Library Building opened next door, the 1926 building became the home of the Houston Metropolitan Research Center and was named for Julia Ideson.
I've always felt that history is an incredibly important thing because we all live in a continuum that carries us from past to present to future. The Houston Metropolitan Research Center is sort of like stepping into a place where you can touch time, and you can read time, and you can feel it, and in terms of this building, you can also smell it.
The newspaper collection includes early Houston newspapers that date back to the days of the Republic of Texas. Also included in the collection are newspapers of Texas trade and labor organizations, as well as ethnic newspapers. The newspaper collection is an important resource for those who are researching the lifestyles of people who lived in Houston in the 19th and 20th centuries. The collection provides a valuable insight about what went on during that time. Architect Barry Moore discovered a treasure of rare circus posters in the HMRC.
When I was helping to catalog the collection, I heard somebody mention, oh yeah, we have a large circus poster collection. And my ears immediately perked right up because my family always had friends that were an important part of the Ringling Brothers show, and they were people that we would see on an annual basis when they came to Houston. So I was taken across the hall and said, here it is. And this was just a huge, huge pile of posters, and it was absolutely breathtaking. These are all posters from a kind of an entertainment that doesn't exist anymore. These are shows under canvas tents. Everything traveled on the train, and elephants pull the tents up instead of tractors, and it was a very much of a 19th century phenomenon that was before your eyes until the middle of the 1950s. It was great to look at these things because it says Buffalo Stadium, fireproof canvas, and all of this meant so much to me because whenever the circus came to Houston when I was small, we'd spend the better part of the weekend out there on the parking lot of Buff Stadium. The past for me has always been extremely alive and extremely visceral.
Buff Stadium, the Rice Hotel, the Majestic Theater, Kirby Mansion, Hughes Tool Company, Freedmanstown, the San Jacinto Monument, all part of the glorious history of this once small community on the banks of Buffalo Bayou that became Houston. Thanks to the vision and tender care of historians, archivists, librarians, and concerned citizens, its history is preserved at the Houston Metropolitan Research Center.
The thing about history is the history of our built environment. Historic buildings like the Julia Ideson Building are incredibly important, and to preserve as much of that as you can is a way to say the city is a living organism.
To come here and experience it is something that you don't forget. It connects us with our past because in a city like ours, which prides itself on moving very quickly into the future all the time, oftentimes we forget about the roots that allowed this kind of growth to happen.
I always believe that in order for you to really understand your future and how to advance upon what exists, you need to know something about the history. You need to know the details.
Houston, Texas has a history that's ongoing. It has one that we can learn from, and it has one that we should be conscious to preserve. And institutions like the Houston Metropolitan Research Center play a central role in that preservation.
The history of the Houston area is a multifaceted tapestry woven by all those who lived and worked here. Documents, photographs, and other business and family memorabilia provide a view of what life was like in the days gone by. If you have historical items you'd like to donate to the HMRC so that future generations may learn about the past, contact the Houston Public Library.